For the last 3 days, Kampala City and other major towns have been characterized with numerous free Bobi Wine protests that had left several people pondering about the country's stability. While addressing the media today, the Minister of Foreign Affairs, Sam Kutesa, said that there is no need for panic since the country is now stable.
No crisis is there in the country at all. There is some disturbance, there is violence, but the rule of law will prevail. And therefore, I don't think it is affecting our image, except that I don't blame you, the usual media, but social media is very interesting. At least for you, you can interview me and represent what I am saying. But social media these days can fabricate stories, even kill someone when he's alive.
The journalists were also urged to be balanced in their reporting.
We got this summit to seek new opportunities for Uganda, opportunities for industrialization, opportunities for creating employment, opportunities, for example, easing or lessening the cost of doing business in Uganda through, for example, the standard gauge railway, creating industrial parks.
China-Africa cooperation will serve as a good example of win-win development between developing countries. China has been Africa's largest trading partner for 9 years straight. In 2017, trade between China and Africa topped $170 million.
China has been Africa's largest trading partner, and in 2017, trade between China and Africa topped $170 billion, 17 times higher than where it stood in 2000 when FOCAC was launched. The theme of the upcoming summit is China and Africa toward an ever stronger community with a shared future through win-win cooperation. I'm Dennis Wanyala for Urban TV.